So some of the stuff that happened since our last update on August 15th, we had a group of young women here who were visiting the community. They visited several places. They were with the Canadian Roots Exchange Group, and we spent an afternoon with them. On 18th of August, we also had a spiritual gathering by the Seventh-day Adventist Church, which was held at the community hall. I was there to welcome them to the community, and I spoke to them a bit about the residential schools. The same day, there were some events being held at Vets Park to celebrate Pride Day. So we had Pride events here at Six Nations, and I think this is the fourth time we've done that, to recognize and support our two-spirited people. I was in Ottawa that weekend, August 19th to 22nd, to attend the Association of Municipalities of Ontario annual conference. And so I went up to Ottawa earlier and went to the Calabogie Blues Festival, which is located, Calabogie is just located outside of Ottawa, because they were featuring a number of artists here from Six Nations. Josh Miller and the Pappy Johns Band were there, Joel Johnson Band and Murray Porter. And as I was in the crowd, they asked me to say a few words. So I just talked about how proud we are of our artists, and they even made the suggestion that maybe we should consider having a blues festival here at Six Nations. So let's keep that in the back of our minds for maybe next summer. As I said, I attended the Association of Municipalities of Ontario conference, was introduced to the crowd, and that is a collection or a conference of mayors throughout Ontario. While I was there, I also had the opportunity to meet with Caroline Mulrooney, who is the new Attorney General for Ontario, talk to her a bit about the whole justice system and a little bit about cannabis, and we'll continue discussions with her. On August 22nd, the Chiefs of Ontario held an information session here in our community about achieving First Nation health transformation in Ontario. And on the 23rd, I want to thank Lori Davis Hill, who attended for me at the 20th anniversary celebration for Doha de Desne in Hamilton, which is the health access center there. I was unable to attend because I was down the street at the Hamilton Tiger Cats game. They were playing against the Edmonton Eskimos, and I was asked to come and welcome everybody to the traditional territory of the Haudenosaunee along with many other nations. So that was an exciting event, particularly because Hamilton won the game in the last minute. And on the 27th of August, I was in Toronto with councillors Charlie Wayne Martin and Terry General. We were attending a housing summit that was organized by Indigenous Services. And on the 28th, we were at the Children's Hospital at McMaster for the grand opening of Michaela's Room. It was a wonderful event, and it was a very emotional day for everybody there. But I just want to congratulate Ken and Sonia Salt and who worked with the hospital in getting this room open so that other families who have to use that hospital are able to go in there for some solitude and able to practice and learn more about our own Indigenous culture and have that safe space. And on the 5th, I also met with others, and Councillor Ray Miracle attended with me. We met with people at the province to talk about the formation of a new Ontario Indigenous sports body. So that work is continuing. And I also had a couple of conference calls with the Political Confederacy of the Chiefs of Ontario on September 6th and 7th. And during that time, 6th to the 9th, we had our Six Nations Fall Fair. And I want to congratulate the committee and all the community members who volunteered to help put this fair on. The particularly exciting part for me was having the harness racing back for the second year in a row, and I think it was a big draw to get more people there. It was a little bit cold, but it was a good event, and I really want to thank the people, and they promised that next year is going to be even better. And as I mentioned, we had just returned from the Assembly of First Nations Forum on the Federal Recognition of Rights Framework, which was held in Ottawa earlier this week from September 10th to 12th.